fire department in the world. What is your name, please?
My name is Edward Thompson.
My name is Edward Thompson.
My name is Edward Thompson.
Only one of these men is the real Edward Thompson. The other two are imposters and will try to fool this panel. Tom Poston, star of My Fair Lady on Broadway, Miss Margot Oser, Johnny Carson, and Betty White, on To Tell the Truth with your host, Bud Collier.
Thank you very much, and welcome once again to Tell the Truth, brought to you this week by Dristan Nasal Mist, the new decongestant spray for relief from miseries of sinus congestion and head cold. Good evening, panel.
Hi, Bud.
Hi, Bud.
Margot, Betty, real nice to welcome you back to the show.
Nice to be back. Thanks, Bud. I'm glad to be here.
Will you open your envelopes for the first time, take out your affidavit cards, and follow along with me as I read from this first affidavit. I, Edward Thompson, am the head of the largest fire department in the world. With 12,000 men and 700 pieces of equipment, we respond to some 200 alarms each day. One-third of these calls, about 20,000 a year, are false alarms. I joined a hook and ladder company as a fireman more than 20 years ago. I am now the fire commissioner of New York City. Signed, Edward Thompson. Gentlemen are comfortably seated. You heard them all claiming to be Edward Thompson, Fire Commissioner of New York City. And let's start the questioning with our own fire putter-otter, Betty White.
Thank you, Bud. First in the chute. Well, first of all, Mr. Thompson, whichever one of you it is, congratulations for a job most well done, believe me, and much appreciated. Number one, what is the largest piece of equipment in your fire department?
Well, the fire truck.
Number two, is that how you would answer that question?
Fireboat.
The fireboat. Number three, what would you say was the largest?
Fireboat.
Number one, how many fireboats do you have?
Nine.
Well, good luck. Number three, what is the most common call that you get other than fire for your services?
Other than fire?
Other than fire.
I would say inspection, really.
Number two, what would you say is the most common call that you get other than fire?
Inspection.
Number one?
Inspection.
Really?
Tom Poston.
I guess now you know. Number three, what was your first admonition or suggestion to the public after you became commissioner? I heard it on the radio. Do you remember what you said?
Yes, indeed I do. Prevent fire.
That's nice of you. He's smoking
there. That's all right. Wouldn't that burn you? Number two, what was the fire department's duty when our Colonel Glenn came to New York City?
We put on a fireboat display.
Where?
In the East River.
East River, thank you. Number one, who decides on the number of patrons at a public hall is allowed to have?
The commissioner of I do.
The commissioner of I do, eh?
The commissioner of I do. The commissioner of marriage. Margot.
Number two, what is the equipment on a fireboat? I mean, what does it include?
Mostly a pump and hose.
How many feet of hose? Number three.
Very little, actually, because we put most of the water out from high-pressure nozzles.
I see. Number three again. Don't you have a long ladder on a fireboat?
Yes, we do. This is subsidiary equipment.
Number one, is there more than one ladder on a fireboat?
Definitely.
Johnny.
Number two, what is the best thing to put on a grease fire if you have burning grease?
Best thing of what?
How do you put out a grease fire? In other words, a grease in the kitchen.
Foam.
Foam? Why wouldn't you put water on it?
Because water won't put it out.
Number one, what is the penalty for turning in a false alarm?
Well, arson, you can get penalty up to 40 years in jail.
40 years?
40 years.
Oh, I see. Number three, who is the former fire commissioner of New York?
Kavanaugh.
Mr. Kavanaugh, what position does he hold now?
Deputy mayor.
Thank you.
That's it. Time for you to try to put your own fires out or start some conflagrations of your own panel as you mark your ballot. Will you do so now? Hot and heavy with the crayon on the ballot. And without consultation, vote now for number one, number two, or number three. Team of challengers will, as usual, receive $250 for every incorrect vote. All ballots marked? Okay, Tom, for whom did you vote?
I voted for number two, that's whom. I thought number three gave certainly the most... I don't know who it is.
Margo, which one do you think is the real one?
Well, I say number three, because I think he gave the most authoritative answers.
Authoritative answers.
Johnny.
I voted for number two, although the biggest thing in the fire department is the wife of Arthur Schwartz, who was on our show several weeks ago. Who is a fireman in town, but I voted for number two.
Betty, what is your vote?
I voted for number three, because he didn't look at us when he sat down, and I think if he's lying, he's not going to look at us. Number two looked us right in the eye. But I thought the second biggest call was for oxygen equipment for heart attacks and resuscitation and like that.
Well, there we have it. Two for two and two for three and none for one. Let's see how right and wrong or in between we may be as we learn now and our own ticket of firefighters try to work on this little spark or two. Who's right and who's wrong as we discover which one of these gentlemen is the fire commissioner of the city of New York. So, will the real Edward Thompson please stand up? Violent about Betty?
Oh, you can't trust anybody. He looked us right in the eye. And
he's the best liar I ever saw.
Number three was great liar. They were all great liars.
Oh, and number three looked so shy and kind of like, well, I'm trying to pretend I'm not it, but I am. And number two was looking like, well, I am really it, and he was.
Okay. You know, 80,000 fires a year is an amazing...
80,000 alarms, 60,000 fires in New York, 20,000 false alarms. Ah. New Yorkers, 90% of them you can prevent. They start because you are careless. Fire prevention is your business every day. Save your lives, save your children.
Hear, hear. Thank you, sir. Can't remind him too often of that, I know. You pick up the papers every day, you see some horrible tragedies. Well, let's find out about these other two gentlemen now. Number one, I'm sorry you didn't get any of the votes, but I'm sure you had a good time. Could you tell us your real name and what you really do, please?
My name is Donald McKay. I'm a salesman for American Banknote Company. In addition to making stocks and bonds, we also make money for many of the foreign countries.
And he got it well. Thank you, sir. And number three, would you tell us your real name and what you really do, please?
I'm James Warren. I'm Executive Vice President of Nautech Corporation, manufacturer of yachts and parking meters.
Any trouble parking your yacht, Pat? You know right where to go now. Well, we checked the score and find that there were two incorrect votes at $250 each for a total of $500 from Dristan, which you gentlemen will get, and parcel up between you. You'll also, of course, receive the gift package of the fine products from the makers of Dristan. And we thank you very much for sharing your time with us tonight. Hope you had fun. Good night to you and God bless. Yes, Tom?
Bud, I have something here I think the audience might find very interesting. It's a book that's going to be published tomorrow. It's called Thou Shalt Not Fear. And it's interesting for several reasons. One is that it's a collection of sermons in verse. And the author is not only a good poet, but also a pretty good television performer. And son of a gun, it's Bud Collier. How about that?
Thank you, Tom.
Thou shalt not fear. Thank you, Bud.
Now let's meet our next team of challengers.
What is your name, please?
My name is Dee O'Hara.
My name is Dee O'Hara.
My name is Dee O'Hara.
Well, you've had your look and you've heard the whistles, and now let's concentrate on the affidavit, if you follow along as I read from my copy. I, Lieutenant D. O'Hara, of the United States Air Force, am a nurse for 7 of the healthiest people in the world. For the past 2 years, I have been working at Cape Canaveral and assigned to the Mercury space program. During actual flights, my post is in the launch medical station. I am the official nurse and the only nurse assigned to the 7 United States astronauts. Signed, Lieutenant D. O'Hara.
Get in touch with Game Show Network. Log on to our website and play our games or email us your questions and comments. It's www.gameshownetwork.com.
Comfortable, ladies? Very well, let's play our game then. And as you heard, panel, these three ladies all claim to be Lieutenant D. O'Hara, nurse to the astronauts. We start our cross-examination with Johnny Carson.
Attention. I give it a try. Number two, how do you learn to give shots? How do you practice?
You learn that in your first 6 months at a nurse's training.
What do you practice on?
People.
Isn't there some other way that you...
Yes, you practice on a rubber ball.
Number one?
You can use a rubber ball or an orange, whichever seems.
That's what I was looking for.
Or people.
Number two, as an officer, are you allowed to go out with enlisted men yet? Has that changed?
No.
Oh. That was my problem. Number three, what is cat fever? Cat fever.
I don't know.
Okay, thank you.
Betty White.
Thank you, Bud. Which of the astronauts was stationed at Bermuda during the launch of Colonel Glenn?
I believe it was Gus Grissom.
And number two, who was stationed in Australia?
Captain Cooper.
Number three, who was stationed in...
Captain Cooper.
Number one, who was stationed in Australia?
Captain Cooper.
Oh, you're no fun. Any one of you, really. Number one, who is scheduled for the next shot? It's been published. It's not security.
I believe it's Zeke Slayton.
You're also smart. Number two, how many connections, wired connections, did Colonel Glenn have when he was actually put into the capsule?
I don't have any idea.
Number three, have you?
Four.
Tom.
Gosh, they're really two. Number one, what is a new test for metabolism?
A new test?
Well, what did they used to use?
Well, they used to use a basal metabolism machine. Which is the end. They can also do it in by drawing blood.
Well, all right, number one. What is the name of that rubber tube that they use when they draw blood? What does it become
they
when they...
They don't really draw it with the tube.
No, but they use it. Okay. Number two, what does metabolism mean? Do you happen to know?
Yes, it's your general blood pressure. And.
All right, General. Number three, do you have anything else that you can add to in the way of defining metabolism?
Yes, I think that's your body makeup. The term for your body makeup.
Pancake.
All right, lady.
You leave me.
Margot.
Number one, what insignia do you wear on your uniform? On your shoulder?
You wear a silver bar or any type of rank which would denote your rank.
Number three, what is the special insignia to designate the astronaut program?
It's an eagle.
Where do you wear it? Number three?
On your collar.
On the collar?
On the collar, on the chevron.
Fred, that's all we have time for, so pull yourselves back from orbit, panel, and seize on to something earthbound, and let's mark a few ballots, shall we? Do so now, please, without consultation. And as you do so, vote as before for number one, number two, or number three. All ballots marked?
No, I haven't marked yet.
Mark them up.
Well,
okay, Tom, what is your selection this time?
Well, I tell you, I wanted to vote for number two because simply because of the way she looked. Only. But then, I didn't care too much for some of her answers. I tried to find one in my memory, but I couldn't. The number one looks wrong to me. She just don't look right to me, son. But I voted for her anyway because of her answers.
Margot.
Well, number one and three, again, that same good old word, authoritative, they were both great. And it's probably number two, so it's I voted for number one.
Johnny, what about your choice?
Number one looks A-okay to me. You were going to say that. No, I have heard that you do practice on an orange. That's why I was interested in that. or a grapefruit, depending
practice
on the patient.
Practice what on an orange?
Giving shots.
Oh, I beg your pardon. Betty.
The last few shots I've had, they were practicing on me. I knew it for you. I voted for number one. She just seemed to have such a calm, direct way not looking at you. I'm going to go that way again. She didn't look at us either when she sat down. I think it's number one.
Well,
I know it's number one.
Well, there you have it. Looks like all systems are go for number one. And we'll see whether we're right or wrong and whether we get into orbit in our own little path here as we track it down the line and as we learn which one of these young ladies is the real nurse to the astronauts. So, Willaria, Lieutenant D. O'Hara, please stand up. I wonder if it was that orange that did it. I don't know, but the panel was real smart that time.
Well,
number
she's
two,
starting to look better to me.
Number two, would you tell us your real name and what you really do, please?
My name is Joy Brunson. I'm a secretary here in New York.
And number three, you who practice giving shots to rubber balls, what is your real name and what do you do?
I usually give them to children. I'm Merle Spears. I'm Dan's wife and Danny's, Marcy's, Patty's, and John's mother.
Well, I must say it was a great, great thrill and pleasure to have you on our show tonight, Lieutenant. And every one of us, United States citizens, is counting on you to take good care of those astronauts in the great Project Mercury.
Thank you
very much for being with us. And of all of you, in checking the score, we find that there were no incorrect votes, but in that case, complimentary-like and sort of as a bit of compensation, you get $150 from Dristan as well as a gift package of the fine products that they make. Thank you so much for being with us. Good night to you all, and God bless you. We represent our third team of challengers.
What is your name, please?
My name is Barnaby Conrad.
My name is Barnaby Conrad.
My name is Barnaby Conrad.
Follow along once again, if you will, please, panel, with your copies of this affidavit. I, Barnaby Conrad, saw my first bullfight when I was 13 years old and fought my first bull when I was 17. Later in Spain, where I was the youngest vice consul in the United States Foreign Service, I studied bullfighting under the great Juan Belmonte and fought some 40 amateur fights. I was seriously injured twice. I turned to writing. My book, Matador, sold over 2.5 million copies. My latest and 12th book is to be published this year. Currently, I am dividing my time between writing a play for fall Broadway production and running my West Coast bistro, which is known appropriately enough as El Matador. Signed, Barnaby Conrad. Three stalwart gentlemen panel, each one claiming to be Barnaby Conrad, intrepid amateur bullfighter, and successful author. And we start this round with Tom Poston. Tom?
With old me?
With old you.
Thank you, Bud. Let me see. Number three, please. Who wrote The Brave Bulls? Do you happen to remember?
Tom Lee.
Number two, who played the part of the manager in the film of The Brave Bulls? I take it your interest would be sufficient to... for you to know this. Do you happen to remember that?
Jack Pallon.
Number one, could you tell me the name of a recent comprehensive volume on bullfighting?
Yes.
Number one?
My Encyclopedia of Bullfighting.
Oh, was that yours? I didn't even know that.
Margot.
Number one, what is the title of your encyclopedia of bullfighting?
Exactly that.
Oh, the encyclopedia of bullfighting.
I bought it.
Number one, name two very famous bullfighters, names with which we would be familiar.
Well, you mean recent bullfighters?
Recent ones, current ones.
Well, I would say Dominguez,
mm-hmm.
Ardoñez.
That's two.
And,
number three, where is Dominguez fighting right now?
I don't know that he is.
Number two, what city is your restaurant El Matador in?
San Francisco.
Johnny.
Number one, is it not true that any color of material could be used to distract the bull, that bulls are colorblind? Is that true?
That's true.
Number two, can you tell me in what city they hold the Festival of the Bulls, where they let the bulls run down the street and the amateurs come out and they chase them through the streets?
Sevilla.
Number three, can you tell me who starred in the motion picture Blood and Sand?
Rudolph Valentino.
Number one, can you tell me who recently finished a book called El Toros?
No, I can't.
Betty.
Number two, what is the organization in England trying to legalize bullfighting there?
I'm not certain of that.
Number three, do you know?
No.
Number one, do you know? Number one, is bullfighting legal in England?
I couldn't tell you. I don't know if it's legal or not.
Number three, is bullfighting legal in this country?
I think it is. I don't know.
Number one, is bullfighting legal in this country?
I would make a guess that it's not, because they fight in Tijuana and Juarez.
And that's it. Panel, leaving it on a very interesting note as to what's legal and what's illegal. I know it's legal for you to mark your ballots now, so will you kindly do so right away? And without consultation, vote now for number one, number two, or number three.
Real sorry.
All set? All ballots marked? Okay, Tom, what is your choice this time?
Well, Bud, I'm going to do something that I never did on this show before. I'm going to disqualify myself at this late date.
Oh, really?
That's why I made the three so vague. I tell you the truth, I think I might have recognized Mr. Conrad from a book jacket that I once saw, but I don't know. His answers were so strange. I didn't know that bullfighting was legal in this country, but I'm disqualified.
You're disqualifying yourself. All right, we count that as an incorrect vote.
Wrong, but
Margot.
Well, I voted for number two only because one and three didn't know if bullfighting was legal in this country. I thought it was illegal. Ms.
Johnny.
Well, I voted for number one. It depends what you mean by bullfighting, whether you kill the bull or not, I believe. You know, you could have bullfighting without killing the bull,
right.
So I voted for one.
That's the best kind, you know that.
The one I'm going to get in.
How was your vote?
Well, I almost switched at the last minute for Margot's reason, but I voted for number one. He looked so pleased when Tom said he bought his book.
All right, now let's find out right now whether or not our panel has awarded the ears, the tail, and all that goes with it. And whether or not they have voted correctly, as we learn which one of these gentlemen is the real amateur bullfighter and author. So will the real Barnaby Conrad please stand up? No, we will. It's too bad. That was the one you thought of.
Now the time to find out if...
I don't think there's an ordinance specifically against bullfighting. I think most people protest bringing bullfighting to this country, as they should. It doesn't belong in this country. It belongs in the Latin country.
Oh, but it's not a law. Oh,
I... There's no law. I don't know.
Okay. Number one, would you tell us your real name and what you really do, please?
My name is Don Cook. I'm a painter, and I teach in the art department at New York University.
Two, may we have your real name and what you do, please?
My name is Alexander Cameron, business development manager of McCall's magazine. And as a matter of fact, I've never been to Spain and never seen a bullfight.
All right, gentlemen, you gave us a lot of pleasure, and I hope we did you too. In checking the score, we find there were 1, 2, 3, 4 incorrect votes for a total of $1,000 from Dristan. Not bad for an evening's entertainment, and if you had as much fun too, that's a plus. You also received a gift package of all the fine products in the makers of Tristan. Thank you, gentlemen.
Who are in or near or will be in or near Palm Beach. Our own Betty White is starring in Light Up the Sky at the Royal Poinciana Theater there. Don't miss it. Guess that's all we have time for, so good night, panel.
Good night, Bud.
Good night, Bud.
Bud Collier saying good night for Dristan Nasal Mist and reminding you to tell the truth. Good night, everybody.
To Tell the Truth is a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Tell the Truth has been brought to you by Concentrated Heat Liquid, the liniment to relieve minor rheumatism, arthritis, or backache pain for hours. Ronnie Olson saying good night, but To Tell the Truth, this program was pre-recorded.